Okay, this morning I just cleared out the mice. We found out living back here, so we've got these doors. These are extra doors. We're gonna eventually put these are the closet doors, and we need to mount those. This is the front door, and these are nice and bedroom doors. We got them for free from the neighbors, and this is how we replaced the doors. It was amazing. They were remodeling their house or something, so they took out all the old doors, which were like score, because these doors, you know, have to be a custom fit. And so that's how we replaced our door and my sister-in-law Ned's door. And then our closet's broken. This one's a little bit broken. I think that's the other one. So the mice have been living back here since we have a rodent problem. We're getting rid of it. These little ones, I forget what they're called. But these are supposed to, they have this sonic noise or something that's, but we don't hear it, but I guess the rodent's supposed to hear it. They hate them. We have like a ton of these. Oh, here's the pesticator. So we have like five or six of those, and we have probably like 20 or so of the other ones all around the house and garage. And then, you know, we have traps and little patch things that they suppose they don't like the smell and all anything. And we have poison, and we had already started right here, but there's more back here. We go anywhere where they think they can kind of hide. And look at this. This is another trip. So this was just the stuff behind here. Can you believe that? What rodents do is it's amazing the stuff they can move or pull. It's weird. I wonder if the whole crew does it sometimes, because they love things like linens or blankets or pillows. And they love things like trash bags and the plastic and stuff. So they'll pull stuff like trash bags. They'll grab them, like, especially like the grocery bag ones. You know, like if you save your grocery bags and use them, you know, for your little small trash cans. They like getting those bags, because you'll find like stashes of garbage bags and then the grocery bag ones. And then they love things like pillows and blankets and stuff, but they shred them and they make their little beds and holes in them. It's disgusting, and rat turds all over. There's mice, mice turds. But that's what you have to pull out, and you have to throw it all out. It's just disgusting. Okay, day 15, all organic beef and water, and no bulimia, and no other food or drink or anything. And I've gotten this closet so clean, and I was just organizing, I was putting my shoes away and stuff. And I'm so excited, like, it's just coming together. And I'm so happy, and I feel so good, and it's just a wonderful day. And we're about to, let's go check out, we're about to. So JR's gonna have the steak today. We need to, oh, here, JR, come on. I have a plate for you. There we go. I also have a knife. We actually have a good knife, and a fork, come on. I have a fork. And I have this really good knife for that. This one. Probably like a really good knife. Okay, and then, okay, so my New York experience was the coolest experience ever, and I don't really want to go back, because, well, for now, we're taking care of my mother-in-law and my sister-in-law. My sister-in-law has actually went to jail last night, because she has schizophrenia, and, they took her, and we don't even know where she's at, which one, and I don't know when they're going to release her or whatever, but it's kind of scary. But anyway, so we have to care for them, and we're, going to save the house for them, because they stopped paying their bills, so we have to, and the house is becoming overtaken by rodents and insects and stuff, and she was a hoarder, so we knew so much. But I just was thinking about New York, and I was like, I'm gonna tear up. I miss it so much. It's hard to describe, like, what New York is like, but I don't want to go back, because we can't relive like what we did. Like, it was, for us, the crazy experience of our whole life. But it's not something you ever want to relive or could relive the way we did. Because for one thing, part of it was that we'd never been there. So it was just like, we're like these babes and like little babies not knowing what. And it was like, and all these crazy things happened, and we were moving like every other day or every day. Sometimes hotels, and, you know, we got kicked out of our place for, you know, just because people were mean and you know, discrimination and stuff, and just all this stuff. But like,
And we got into doing drugs again there, and just, it's crazy experience. And we started eating bad and got back into all of our bad habits, bulimia and everything. And so I wouldn't want to relive it, but it was the best and worst year of my life. But when I first got there, I met this guy named Patrick, and he was young, like 28 or something, and his mom and dad, I think, were dead. And he said, "Have you had a New York minute? A New York minute?" And I said, "No." "And what's that?" And he said, "It's hard to describe, but it'll be like all these things happen in this time that feels like so much, but then it's gonna be really fast at the same time. And it's gonna be just like your New York minute." And he says, "Everyone's gonna have one before they leave New York. You'll have one." And our whole year was our New York minute. Because it's like such a short time now, but it was like the longest time of my entire life, too. I just love New York. But I also don't wanna live there. But I wanna be there. But I don't want to live there. And I don't even want to travel there because you don't want to just travel there. So I don't think we'll ever go back. But we had our New York minute. And it was the best time of my whole life."
Yeah. Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow. But I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra. And since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah,
I love
it everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem. All my Dominicanos right there on Broadway.
Pulled
me back to that McDonald's. Took it to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like the
Simmons. All over Manhattan.
Cruising down
the
streets. On flight Nexus. Driving so
and
slow.
BK
is from Texas. Me, I'm out that bad stop. Home of that boy.
Didn't make it to Hampton. But I don't care,
because
I like this
city. Sitting my tie. Sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets, give me high five. Nigga, I be spiked out. I can trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I'm most definitely in front.
It means so much to me.